Welcome again to Practical Talk. I'm your host, Pastor Wendell Jeffrey. Thanks for joining. Assalamu alaikum, namaste, Christian greetings. In the studio with me today is Dr. Vishnu Bandhu, the leader of the party. And we continue the discourse that we've been having as we seek to shape our national plans and ideas and share it, what it is that we as a political party plan to do for the country. But before we get into that discourse, let's get into our segment talking practically. The parking meter saga is a political red herring of sorts. It has received widespread support because it gave people an area to vent, something to collectively vent about. Persons were able to bridge the political divide, and they picked the city hall because they were able to find common ground on a local issue. But I'm saying it's a red herring of sorts, because if we were to step back, we in Guyana could find a dozen things to pick it about that are way more significant than the parking meter. For instance, constitutional reform, that issue. Guyana has a constitution that has kept it racially and politically polarized for over 50 years. It has also been used to exert force, dictatorial repression on the citizenry, as seen as the prorogation of the parliament and the stalling of government, local election for 20 years. Our lack of progress and our autocratic leadership styles are tied directly to our dictatorial constitution. I believe that our constitution is the only one in the Caribbean that does not follow the Westminster style of governance. We are probably the only Caribbean country that used the proportional representation rather than the first past the post electoral system. That means that you cannot vote for your parliamentary representative. The so-called Bornholm Constitution does not allow you to have a local representative at the central government level. In every Caribbean and first world country, you are allowed to vote for your own parliamentary representative, but not in Guyana. Additionally, no member of a party can vote on any issue independent of the collective party membership. And if they do vote independently, the constitution allows for the immediate eviction from the parliament. Also, the constitution does not allow for parties to collate after an election, which means that even a party with a simple majority can form the government. For instance, Guyana's parliament has 65 seats. If in a three-way race, two of the parties win 20 seats each, the party that won the other 25 seats will form the government. And the two parties with a combined 15-seat majority cannot collate to form the government. Our constitution was drafted by folks who wanted to make sure that they remained in power with ultimate power for life. Of course, we know that the president of Guyana stands immune from the law based on any deeds he commits when he's office. And again, this is only true in Guyana and countries with dictatorial regimes. For years, there have been calls for the reformation of the constitution, but neither of the political bigwigs would push for any substantive change in the constitution. Why? Because it is a gold mine of political repressive powers, and power corrupts. And Guyana's constitution gives the executive absolute power, hence the absolute corruption that we see in Guyana. So if we really want a matter of national significance that we could rally and pick it for, it is the reformation of the 1980 constitution. It has almost single-handedly stifled the growth and the progress of Guyana. And yet, We for personal gains, our politicians continue to wrap themselves in the constitution. It will take the collective force of we the people to bring about the needed reform to our repressive, negative, dictatorial constitution. And that's not a red herring. That's talking practically. Thank you so much. Doc, welcome again.
Thank you.
Welcome again. Blessings. Yeah. Blessings on you. Doc, you're a busy man. In between these programs, you nip out the country and you come back, and persons don't even know that you have gone and that you have come. As you travel, what are you hearing? What's the word on the street as you go to these different countries, Canada, New York, we've been to Trinidad, you're going across the Caribbean. What are persons saying about Guyana?
Guyana hasn't been having a very good name at this moment, in this present government. The diaspora also, who had supported this government overseas, are telling you clearly today that they will not support this government. Many people who have been supporting them, and even in Guyana, who have been supporting, even last night I had a discussion in London. Many people, one of the ex-mayor I met with last night, said, you know, he told me, he said, Dr. Bandu, I think I'll come in aboard with you.
Wow.
Right?
Wow.
Because I am fed up with these two political parties in this country. He's totally fed up. And those are the kind of response that I'm getting all over.
Okay.
Overseas, in Guyana. We have been working very hard.
I know you are.
In fact, our group are having in New York, on the 29th of this month, they're having a fundraising in New York. And I'm going along there for that, so that we can be able to think. And we are forming more and more groups. We are trying to form groups all over the Guyanese, in London, in the Caribbean, and all over the place.
Okay.
We are trying to put groups together.
And you're getting support.
I'm getting. I'm getting
the vision that you're casting.
Yes.
Folks are buying into that.
This is what people are looking for, what we have to offer.
Okay.
That is what they are looking for. In Guyana, we have been working tremendously hard all over, yesterday morning I was doing business in town. I was in Linden. You know, after this program, I'm going to Barbice.
Okay.
And tomorrow, you know, so we on the go all the time.
Right.
You know,
right.
And it is very heartening to know the result that we are having. You know, very, very heartening. Because I think that we are the only political party is out there trying to educate our people, because we realize that education on this political issue is very important.
Okay.
People have to understand and stop being fooled, because you've been fooled over 50 years, you know? And those of us who are elderly should let us try to see that how we can able to influence our children, our friends, our family, and everyone, you know, so that we can able to make a difference in Guyana. And as I said, and I keep on repeating this, racism does not put flour, sugar, and rice and butter on the table. It's a policy, and that's what the URP have to offer you. It's a policy.
And so a part of the task, in addition to going around to see how best you can assist with the local needs as you go around the country and set up your groups, one of the things that you have been tasked with by default is educating the Guyanese people, because the Guyanese folks don't vote issues. Largely, Guyana, we don't vote issues. We vote race and political ideology.
But I think that will change now. You know, you will have a percentage still voting race.
Okay.
But I think that people who are thinking, start thinking differently now.
And you're optimistic to believe that we're going to move past the race issue?
Yes. You know, because maybe the next decade and so you might have race issue in Guyana,
mm-hmm.
but it wouldn't continue. It is a total different in Guyana right now. The older folks, the elderly one, may talk about race, but the young generation does not want to hear about race.
And why you think that is so? You think it's because of the cross relationships? You think it's enlightenment? You think that it is the electronic age, and you see what's happening around the world?
I think it's the electronic age. It's a different time, you know, in our life. Look, in fact, what Mandela have done in his days, or Gandhi, what he had done in his days, can't come and do it today.
Okay.
It's a different time. Okay. It wouldn't work, you know. So you have to live according to time in Guyana.
So the political right? Dinosaurs in Guyana are dying out because,
yes.
You know, what the politicians are good for in Guyana is their ability to use race to their advantage.
It's about all divide and rule. This is the communistic system and the socialistic system. It's dividing and rule, right?
Okay.
It's not ruling as one, but divide. You are black, you're Indian. Well, I want to see how long they will do that now. Because we have in Guyana, we have, I think, approximately 39% Indian, but 33% black. We have a 20% mixture in this country. Let me see how they're gonna do this now.
Yeah.
Right? And no one political party in Guyana who go in that line will ever won an election in this country.
You have to cross over. You have to cross over.
You know, they can't, right? URP might have a better chance than them in doing this. Because URP are talking about unity.
Beautiful.
Talking about our people. Mm-hmm. We're talking about our love. If we don't have love for our people, how would we serve them? We can't serve them if we don't have that love. Mm-hmm. If we don't have that caring, that feelings for them. Right? Look, I went in Kanji last week, and I sat down with the chief of traffic police father, and I go and I sit with him, the black fellow, somebody introduced me to him, and you know he had to talk over and over, doctor. You are the man for this country.
Wow.
Right? Because you are so simple. You know, you are the people's person. And I never know you, but I am telling you, this is my feelings.
Wow.
Right? That you are the people's person.
Yes, spirit,
in Guyana.
Spirit, you know, they say, you know, spirit is,
yeah,
is like spirit, right?
You see?
We are kindred.
You know? Yeah, I never see this guy before. He never saw me before.
Mm-hmm.
In a couple minutes, he started telling me this, you know? So, you know, the point is, what I get, if something affects my people, right, it affects me.
And in your, when you
right?
say your people, you're talking about the Guyanese people.
I am talking
people.
About the Guyanese people, right? It affects me.
Beautiful.
If I have my birthday, I can't go and keep a big party when I know my people are suffering, eh? And many of them don't have a meal. But you know, you show me which one of them in government, in the past administration and this administration, will do that. All they concern is about themselves. I concern about my people.
People, you sound like President Moody.
No, I concern about my people.
Yes.
And that's my feelings.
Yes.
Whatever I'm saying here on this program, I'm saying from my heart.
And it comes through, and that is why I like to allow you to really express yourself, because I think that the word that I get is that your heart is in the right place, right? When people talk to me about the program, they say that they think that you come across as a genuine person, and it is ironic that a person would vote for somebody who is articulate or who comes across as academically inclined, while the person who is more emotive and who has the heart of the people is likely to be slighted, if only because they don't meet some of these societal barometers. So I like when you talk and when you express yourself and people get to read you, you know, and they get to read you. Talk about the holistic approach to the racial situation in Guyana, because we just don't have two races in Guyana. You know, we have the Indians and we have the blacks, but there are some other people who sometimes get sidelined because we are so caught up in meeting the needs of these two things for political gains, you know. Yeah.
Well, you see, I have been going around the country and I have been meeting with all kinds of people. Mm-hmm. Lots of Amerindian. I form a lot of Amerindian groups already across the country, in mixture area and so forth, like all those in outline area from Linden. Mm-hmm. It's more mixed people. Okay. They don't know about race there. They don't want to hear about race. You know where the race created in Guyana? In the city. Georgetown, New Amsterdam, all where they call city, Linden has race. You know, because these people are not thinking straight. Many of them, not all, mm-hmm. many of them is not thinking straight, you know, and there where the racism come about. Now, the two administrations, the PPP and the PNC, they have been talking about blacks and they have been talking about Indians. Now you see they're all normal, mm-hmm. but you see when the election bell rang, mm-hmm. the race start, you know?
The race.
The PNC go and tell the black people, mm-hmm. look, I have tried to make this PPP, this coolie man, and go in there. Mm-hmm. And you are in big trouble. Mm-hmm. And the same thing the PPP go in and tell their supporter, now make the black people, you see what they want, you'll be in big trouble.
Now, Doc, I want to know if you want to talk a little about, here you are the leader of this party and you are Indian. What are some of the, are you taking any heat for that?
Well, no.
I mean, in the sense of from the politicians. Are the politicians bringing to bear any, you know, what are they saying about you as an Indian running another party? Do they think that you are going to affect the Indian vote?
Oh, yes. Yeah, they think that. But I am not thinking in that line. I'm not thinking about Indian. Mm-hmm. I am thinking about all Guyanese. Okay. That's a different. And if any one of them try, in fact, one or two try to come and tell me those things, and I say, hey, stop it right there. Okay. I am a Guyanese. Don't bring this race talk with me. And this race talk has us in this position today. Right? So nobody can bring those kind of talk to me. Right? I have my own mind. I count myself as a people's person, right? I love my people. I care for my people. I'm very sincere in what I'm doing. I'm not doing this with any kind of thing. I don't know. You know, I always mention to you, I don't know how long God will permit me. But you know what? I will continue doing this as long as I have breath in my body and I have this energy that God gives me. I will continue doing it. And I am not looking at I'm an Indian, because a lot of Indian, I'll tell you this. A lot of Indian, if you have an issue and you call them to protest out there, you don't see none. Okay. But if I go and call the black people and the other race, you see them come out. Right? This is how Indian are. They want you to work and they enjoy. I'm telling you clear. I'm an Indian. I'm telling you that. This is how we operate. This is how naive they are. So I am not worrying about Indian. I'm not, if the PPP think I will take away Indian support, I don't take away Indian support. You know, if you want to support us and you have an open mind, come and support us. Right? You want to support the PPP? Support that. That's your democratic right. That's what democracy is all about. And we are inviting people to come and listen to us. And I tell you clearly, listen to us. If we make sense, then try to work with us.
Beautiful.
If we don't make sense, forget about us.
You're appealing to people's rational thinking.
Yes.
Right? So you come to the table and you say, look, what it is that we are suggesting, how do we sound compared to what you've been hearing? For 50 years, you've been hearing basically two political parties, and Guyana is still the most backward country of the Caribbean. Do we still want to continue with the behaviors that have brought us to this point?
Pastor, many of our groups, I tell them, I said, look, if I had a political party having a meeting, go listen to them.
Okay.
Right? You go and listen to them. And you will understand our way of teaching and their way of teaching. And then you will be able to come to a real understanding.
Compare.
And compare us. Mm-hmm. What kind of people. But you know what? The PPP and the PNC. If you have a meeting, if you are, we have a meeting, and one of their members come and somebody else see them, it's trouble.
Yeah, because,
why should you go and listen to them?
Yeah.
But you have to have that open mind.
Yeah.
You know, many of our Indian people are more close-minded than the black people in this country. I'm telling you that. I'm dealing in this country. I know what I'm saying. I have been able to attract all the five other races more than my own race in Guyana. Because you know what? This thing in their head, you know, die out there, the PPP, and all these kind of things in their head. But I want to know if PPP will able to do anything for them, because there are a lot of places. Look, they had a meeting in Crabwood Creek the other day. 22 people they have at the meeting, a bottom house meeting.
The PPP.
Where the ex-Prime Minister, Roger Lanchon, and I think the former Attorney General. And one person was made, because our representative was there in that meeting, stand up and said, look, you are not in government now. What? And when you all was in government, you don't come here.
Wow.
Right? Wow. But you are not in government now. What can you guys do for us?
Okay.
After a couple of minutes, the meeting finished. In the last half an hour, I was made to understand.
Wow.
We keep a meeting in the same, actually, area. We had about 140 people.
Wow.
In that same area. Right?
So there's an evolving of the thought process. People are moving away. Maybe, probably the younger generation, they are moving away from this diehard political ideology and the racism. What you're saying is that you're seeing some growth in that area.
That is what I'm saying.
Beautiful.
That throughout the country, you are seeing that people, many of them are telling you that, look, we fed up money with these two political parties, right? If we don't get something new, we are not going out and vote.
Wow.
Right? They're telling you that clearly. I heard that even last night.
Wow.
Right?
Wow.
In Linden. Many way you go, you see. Black Bush, I heard that. I heard that in the quarantine. I heard that in Ezekiel. The same song. And these people never meet and talk. But this is the feelings of them.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And I'm telling you that the URP will surprise a lot of people in Guyana.
Well, I believe so too. Now, a lot of people, and this program that we're doing, and the newspaper articles that you write and so on, people are getting to know more about the party, the outreaches that you're doing. And I think that there will be developing silent majority out there, where people will decide, look, let's try something different. For the sake of Guyana, because what we do right now is we were doing the old thing because of our political allegiance and so on. But I think that folks will eventually say, you know something? Let's try something new, because that is what it will take to really take Guyana to another level. We can't continue to do what we've been doing for the last 50 years and expect that we will realize the change that we want to see. Gotta try something new.
We have been getting tremendous support. Look in our Facebook. You know, I had a Facebook on URP that only takes 50 likes. In the space of 2 to 3 months, you got maximum 5,000.
Okay.
It closed off. You can't take more.
Wow.
We had to open the next Facebook.
Wow.
Right?
Wow.
Because it was designed in that way. When we opened it, we didn't understand it.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So that alone is telling you, and we're having a lot of people who are responding to the Facebook, sending their number for me to call them, and I have been calling them.
Beautiful.
You know, and talking to them on the thing, and they all, you know, pour out their heart and their feelings, you know, and they will support the URP. So the URP is moving on. Slowly we are moving on, right? And I'll tell you that we will make such an impact in Guyana coming this election. A change has to be in Guyana.
Well, we know that the change is in the air. And now before we run out of time, I want you to talk a little about the sugar problem. We a lot of people, the Wales, and you live right there by the Wales estate, and we got the kanji now. What are we doing with the people whose livelihood depend on the estates?
This alone will show you that this government does not think about the people. They does not think, because the URP are saying all the time, okay, if you insist on closing the estate, distribute the land. Don't look for buyers. Distribute the land to the workers.
Okay.
You are saying again that the government are bailing out billions of dollars in the sugar industry.
Mm-hmm.
Take a part of the billions of dollars and give it to these people to start cultivate the land. And only one time you have to do that, right? And next thing they have to do also when they do that, they have to try to, not saying that government don't concern about the marketing system.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this is the first country I heard that government don't want to be involved in those kind of things. Government is not to find job for people. This is the first country I ever heard it saying those kind of things. You know, all countries, even the first world countries, they're telling you clearly,
the farmers and
right,
stuff like that.
They have to support their farmers.
Correct.
They have to create job for their people.
Correct.
More job they create, their country will be in a better position.
Correct.
But our country doesn't have that. Because why? We, the leaders who we have in our country, don't have the brain to go in that route.
Okay.
You know, not going to university give you brain, you know. Going to university, you go to get a degree.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't give you the brain. How many people have degree in the world and this country?
Can't find
jobs. And not find job, and they don't have nothing called wealth.
Mm-hmm.
And the ordinary common man, using his common sense, he bypasses and he have millions and billions of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
It makes me remember when I first go to the United States in 81. They had a 82. They had a survey done with professionals,
okay,
as businessmen,
mm-hmm,
and people just go to high school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, who are the bigger percentage?
Right.
And it showed that the ordinary man,
of course,
had 80% of the most successful business people.
Yeah, well, we know that.
And 20% is the professional.
In fact, it is the non-graduates who hire the graduates.
Yes.
I mean, yes. You know, Gerald Ford, and who came up with the invention of the cars. The guy from IBM, you know. You know, so we know that. So Doc, what we're saying here is that there have to be some formal approach to reducing the stresses which come with these people losing their livelihood.
The hurtful thing is Pastor, that all these people who in the cane belt and the rice area and so on, most of these people had supported the PPP. And you know the PPP are not paying no attention to them. You're not hearing. They talk about kanji clothing down. The PPP, you don't hear they go down there and try to make a some kind of compromise with these people or talk about it. All the people is there. I had meeting with them. All of them are wondering, oh God, if this estate closed down, we'll be a ghost town just like Wales. You know? But you're not hearing these PPP people going. But you know what? I told them, I said, you know what? When the election bell ring, they'll come here, they'll make promises to you, what they can't even deliver. And you will fall for it, and you go down that road again. So who to be blamed?
You got blamed.
You blame you, the people. Because this is your idea, your thought. You trusting these people. Look, we have trusted people at PNC 28 years. We bring them back, we trust them again, and you see what's happened? Huh? So what are we going to do? We had PPP 23 years. You're going to bring them back. What do you think will happen? And remember, as Bharat Jagdev said the other day, you know, he will not remember or forget these things, what is happening. So that is already
a promise.
A promise.
Yeah, folks, I tell you, Doc, thank you so much. We, you know, this half an hour comes and it runs out so fast. Folks, you understand what we're doing. We're saying you can't keep doing the same thing, expecting different results. We have to have a third party in this country to create a balance in the parliament, and the URP is reaching out to you. Thanks for joining us. God bless you real good. Join us next week, same time, same station. Follow us on the World Wide Web. www.urp.com, urpguyana.com, and our Facebook page is URP Guyana. God bless you. We're out of time. Take care.